In this lecture, we talked about short-run and long-run production. In the short run, you can change your variable inputs like labor. You could hire a new worker tomorrow or fire someone today. But you can't change your fixed inputs like capital in the short run. For example, suppose you run a pizza shop. Maybe you realize you don't need 2 pizza ovens, or maybe demand is crazy and you wish you had 10 pizza ovens. In the short run, there's nothing you can do about that. You could hire or fire workers to meet demand, but you're stuck with the number of ovens you bought. But in the long run, you can adjust your capital, like the number of pizza ovens you have. But is this just a convenient way of thinking about production, or does it also have some real-world application? You may have heard of Tesla Motors. It's the hottest car company in the world, maybe the hottest company in the world, period. It was founded in 2003 and produces electric cars. How good are the cars? Consumer Reports is a magazine that rates all cars using a system that takes into account performance, efficiency, beauty, and cost. And in 2015, Tesla's Model S did so well that it literally broke the Consumer Reports point system. It's fair to say Tesla's the most exciting car company out there. All that said, it's still a tiny company compared to other car manufacturers. It expects to produce only 20,000 cars in 2017. Compare that to Toyota. They make over 10 million cars per year. Tesla's incredible popularity is both a blessing and a curse. Over 200,000 people have reserved the Tesla Model S. That means that there'll be a huge backlog of over 180,000 orders. People have to wait several years after ordering a Tesla before they can drive it. This is where short-term versus long-term production matters. Tesla was surprised by its popularity. Even though hundreds of thousands of people want its cars, it can't ramp up production enough to meet demand for several years. Tesla can hire more workers, run double or triple shifts, and increase production a little, but nowhere near enough to meet demand. But in the long run, Tesla's fixing the problem. This past year, they announced they're building the largest electric car battery factory in the world in Nevada. This will allow them to increase production to about 500,000 cars per year. This would solve their waitlist problem. Now, of course, 500,000 is more than their existing backlog. If that ends up being too many, in the next short run, Tesla will be stuck with too much capital, and they might have to cut it back. That's the nature of long-run production. It takes a long time to adjust to changes in demand. The bottom line is that the same model we discussed this lecture is something real companies grapple with. How you make decisions in the short run is different from what you do in the long run. Of course, this is bad news for the Tesla buyers who have to wait half a decade to get a car. Sorry, Tesla buyers. You can't do anything about fixed costs in the short run, but at least you'll have a cool car one day.